Today we are going to discuss about pulse code modulation. At the end of this session, what we expect from students that students will be able to explain basic blocks of PCM. They must be also able to describe advantages and disadvantages. They must be able to differentiate linear and non-linear quantization. These are the contents of this session that we are going to discuss. First, the basic block diagram of the PCM system. We'll be discussing the advantages, disadvantages, and few applications. Now let us start with the basic block diagram of the PCM system. Here you can see in this figure, the PCM system consists of three basic blocks. Those are sampler, quantizer, and the encoder. Now, the function of the sampler, that you all you know that it is going to take the sample of the input signal, but it has to satisfy the basic theorem of the sampling theorem. What it states that the sampling frequency must be at least twice of the maximum input signal frequency. So this is, we are going to assume that the sampling frequency is twice of the input signal frequency. Now, here we see that the output of the sampler, here it consists of number of samples. So depending on the frequency, we have a different samples at different time instants. So at that time instant, whatever the sample value is there, those will be the outputs. So here we can see here, there are different samples of different sampling values. Now, this output is given to the quantizer. Now, what is the function of the quantizer? Is that it is going to approximate the real-time sample values. So here you can see the basic process. Here we see that different amplitudes, sample values, and those are approximate values that we can see here. So here, for example, if we see that if the sample value is say 2.2 volts, so in this quantization level, we see that it is lying between 2 volts and 3 volts. So here the approximation process will start. It will see that it is more closer to the 2 than the 3, and the approximation taken is that is the actual quantized value is considered as a 2 volts. Another example, for example, if the, say for example here, the sample value is say 0.2 volts. So while quantizing, it checks that it is in between two quantization levels, that is, it is going to check between 0 and 1 volt, and it is approximated to the 0 volt because it is closer to the 0 volt than the 1 volt. So approximation taken as 1. So here, the quantization is nothing but an approximation. So the actual sample values are approximated to the known standard values. So the difference between the two quantization levels is also known as step size. Now the output of the quantizer, it is given to an encoder. So the function of the encoder is that depending on the number of quantization levels, the number of bits for that those sample values, those are decided. For example, if there are four quantization levels, then the encoding bits required will be 2 bits. How this we can get it? It all depends on the number of quantization levels. So in general, what we can say that if m is the number of quantization levels, then log m to the base 2. Now, for example, if there are 4 quantization levels, log 4 to the base 2, that comes to 2. So that means for each and every sample, those are specified with the 2 encoding bits. If there are 8 quantization levels, so log 8 to the base 2, that comes to 3 bits. That specifies that every sample is represented by 3 bits. So the output of encoder, it is nothing but simply in those are represented in the form of 1s and zeros. So the analog signal is converted in 1010 form. So it is a binary representation. Now, what we have discussed up till now. So any data which is analog in nature must be translated into a series of binary digits before they can be transmitted. Also, the amplitude of the sound, for example, voice data, wave is sampled at regular intervals and translated into binary numbers with pulse code modulation. The difference between the original analog signal and the translated digital signal is called quantization error. As we have here, we have observed that when the real-time sample value, when it is approximate to the known standard value, there always some difference is going to be occur, and that difference is known as quantization error. Now, the analog signal is sampled every TS seconds, that is a time interval. This is referred as the sampling interval. The sampling frequency can be calculated. If you know the sampling time period, it is 1 upon TS, we get the sampling frequency. The samples have three different shapes, or we can say three different methods that we can observe here. So first is an ideal case, that is an impulse at each sampling instant. Natural, a pulse of short width with varying amplitude, varying shape, that we can see it. Flat top, where pulses will have the flat shape. So you don't have the natural shape of the input signal. So here, we can get such type of flat outputs by using sample and hold circuits. Now, we have discussed about the quantization. Now, think what can be the different possible types of the quantization. So, quantization broadly are of two types, linear quantization and non-linear quantization. Linear quantization is also known as uniform quantization, and non-linear quantization is also known as non-uniform quantization. To decrease the distortion, the number of steps in the given amplitude range has to be increased. More quantization levels in small amplitude region and less quantization levels in large amplitude region are planned, and this results to non-linear quantization, also called non-uniform quantization. Now, how we can calculate the bit rate or the bandwidth of the PCM system? The PCM bit rate of a given signal can be calculated from the number of bits per sample multiplied by the sampling rate. So in short, what we can say that bit rate is equal to number of bits per sample into FS, that is the sampling frequency. A digitized signal will always need more bandwidth than the original analog signal. The bandwidth required to transmit the signal depends on the type of line encoding used. Here, different line encoders are there, like NRZL, NRZM, return to bias, biphase Manchester. So there are different. So depending on the type of line coding used, the bandwidth is going to vary. So what are the advantages of the PCM? With the PCM, we can have uniform transmission quality. It is compatible to different classes of traffic in the network, integrated digital network. Increased utilization of existing circuit. Good performance over poor transmission paths. Low manufacturing cost. So what are the disadvantages of the PCM? Inter-symbol interference is the major problem of the PCM system. Noise and crosstalk leaves low but rises the attenuation. This requires large bandwidth for transmission than analog type. An integrated digital network can be realized. Some applications of the PCM system, that the PCM systems can be used in digital telephony. We all know that. Typical sampling frequency used in telephony is 8 kHz. PCM is also used in compact discs. also used in digital audio application. As we all know that the enhanced PCM systems are DPCM and the ADPCM. So where data compression techniques are widely used. So the PCM is the basic building block of all these techniques.